Hello everybody. Today I'm sitting with Aditya Ahluwalia, who's the publisher and founder of Life Positive, and I wish to ask him as to how he turned towards spirituality.
I think like most people, there is a defining moment, you know, in one's life when one forgoes the path that one is on and decides to choose a new path or move in a totally new direction. From birth, I was religious, you know, the religion of my birth in which I was born in, I was religious and, you know, but around the age of around 15 or 16, my family went through a big transformation, a big tragedy in the family actually, and then I was questioning at that time the existence of God and the purpose of religion and things like that. And doing that turned me into an atheist actually. I stopped believing in God. I said, how can God let this happen? How can this happen if God truly existed? So that was, I think, about the age of around 15, 16. I was in class, between class 10, grade 10 and 11. That this took place. And then I remained atheist for a while, and from atheist then I turned into an agnostic, which means that I'll believe in God in case the God truly exists. And then I was agnostic for a while, trying to, you know, see or somehow to for it to come to me that God exists, but it did not. So I realized that God is obviously not looking for me, so probably I have to go look for God and see if it exists. So prove the non-existence of God, so as to say. So fortunately, I was actually, in a place, I was studying in a boarding school which had a very good library with books on philosophy and religion and ancient scriptures. And so to search for God, or the meaning of God, or the even there is existence of God possible, I started looking at various philosophers and read all the religious scriptures at that time, from the Gita to the Quran and the Bible and so on. I read Vivekananda, Sri Aurobindo, Bertrand Russell, many philosophers. And while reading some of those books, I got my answers. So I found my answers in some of the books which were more philosophical, actually more specifically at that time in the writings of Sri Aurobindo, because the religious books, or at least my understanding of the religious books, did not give me a good understanding of spirituality, or did not give me the answers to the questions I was looking for. So from religion at that point, I turned into spirituality and also began my process of meditating and contemplation along with it.
So did you start meditating by yourself, reading some books or watching some videos, or did you take the meditation classes under somebody's guidance?
When I first started meditating, I just knew that I have to make my mind blank. And the reason for this is we are evolutionary beings. We have evolved from animals and apes to become humans. And to become from animals to humans, we have given up something and acquired something. We of course gave up our physical prowess, but we gained our mental prowess. So essentially we are mental beings. And to reach the next rung on the on the evolutionary ladder, we have to give up the dependence on our mind and go to the next level, which is more psychic and intuition, and be in touch more with a psychic being and not think so much from the mind. So right now the mind is a block which was help to us to evolve from the animal form to the human form, but right now it's a block. There's too much going on my on our minds to move to the next rung of evolution. So I knew that I have to silence the mind, and only then I can evolve. This was clear to me. So for the first 15 years, I do not even remember how I did it. I just experimented myself with various forms of silencing the mind. I would go on a trek or a hike, you know, in the Himalayas, a school trip, a college trip. I would just find a nice spot somewhere and just sit down, watch with the nature, and not think of anything. And I was able to do it. I think it was more a practice because I was doing it on a much regular basis. And I still cannot, you know, put a process together, whether it was my breathing. I don't think I was breathing anything differently or anything. It was just, I think, something which just came naturally because I was so determined to do it that I wanted to silence my mind in some ways. But now some masters also say that the more you want to silence your mind, the more, you know, the thoughts will come to you. So I really don't know how it happened. But for the first 15 years until I actually met a few masters and who guided me into you know, a structured method of meditation and different meditation processes, I was just experimenting and able to silence my mind for some periods of time, which I also don't know what those periods were, because once I would go into meditation, I would lose track of time, and when I would come out of it, I really wouldn't know whether it was 15 minutes or 10 minutes or 20 minutes or half an hour. But it was effective, I can tell you that, because I evolved a lot during those periods, and some very beautiful experiences came to me during that period. Maybe it was my innocence, it was my meditation, or maybe a combination of the two. I'm not sure.